presidential candidate of the Sri Lanka Pothujana Perumara Gotabaya Rajapaksa addressed a number of public rallies held in Gampaha today.
This was the reception received by presidential candidate Gotabaya Rajapaksa in Kanyamunga today. After the SLPP won the provincial council elections and proved our strength to everyone, our national organizer Basil Rajapaksa summoned all of us and prepared us for the upcoming presidential election. We toured across the country, we even visited Jaffna, we visited Batticlo. We have prepared all of our electorates for the upcoming presidential election. On the 16th of November, all our efforts will be realized. Gotabaya Rajapaksa will win the presidential election with 60% of the total voter base. Gotabaya Rajapaksa will take oaths as the president of this country on the 17th of November. And within a few days, Mahinda Rajapaksa will be appointed as the prime minister of this country.
අපි ඉදිරි වැඩසටහන අපි ජයග්‍රහණයෙන් පස්සේ අපේ රටේ ආරක්ෂාව තහවුරු කරන ආකාරය
We presented our manifesto with our strategy as to how we will strengthen national security, provide education and training to our youth, develop our economy and how we will protect the environment. These strategies were prepared by intellectuals, experts, businessmen and professionals. Through the Pilisandra program that was conducted at village level, we identified the issues of the general public and presented our program with practical solutions for these issues. I pledged to implement all of my plans during my tenure. When I attended public rallies in several areas and spoke to the locals, their only request was to save this country and to protect it.
අපේ රට අපිට ආපහු ලබා දෙන්න කියලා. අපේ විරුවා බෞබිමට පෙමින් සවද රට රකින්න කෙනෙක් බේරම් ඒ ඔබයි යුතුම් මිනිසා වැඩ කරන අපේ විරුවා බෞබිමට පෙමින් සවද
Gotabaya Rajapaksa addressed public rallies which were held in Kurunagala yesterday.
විතලසින් ඉස්තම්මව එලේ අභිමානේ වෙන්වා දෙමින් මුළු ලොව දින අපහායන ගමනේ නොවනම් වෙසින් නාවක් මැසේ
Gotabaya Rajapaksa, who arrived in Mavathagama, was afforded a warm welcome by those in the area.
We have given a large number of tax reliefs to businessmen in the agricultural sector. There are many entrepreneurs and businessmen who are engaged in the coconut industry. Today there is a complex tax system set in place. It has been recommended that we remove this complex system and introduce a simplified system. Unnecessary taxes will be removed. Through this, we intend to motivate businessmen engaged in these sectors to increase production, to increase investment, to increase consumption, and of course, to strengthen the economy. That is when jobs will be created. That is when new businesses will be formed. State revenue will increase through that, through a more simplified, transparent tax system. We can allow those engaged in the managing of taxes to also conduct their duties easier. We can also eradicate the corruption which takes place within the complex tax system.
බදුනිසා ඇතිවන දූෂණය අපිට වළක්වන්නට පුළුවන්.
හිතුනන බලෙන්
ලොව පරතන මිනිස් පෞර සදන රටදය සදාම විත කරන්නට තුර දැක්මෙන් සිතන
පියසක නැති යුගයක් මවා.
Gotabaya Rajapaksa also attended a meeting which was held at the community hall in Panmala last night.
මේ රටේ ගුහි තැන දියුණු කරනා වගේම මේ රටේ කර්මාන්ත ඇති කරන්න අපි විශේෂ අවධානය යොමු කරනවා.
We will direct special attention towards developing farming as well as strengthening industries. The apparel industry has been introduced to villages now. We believe we should convert the apparel industry so that it protects the working rights of those employed and it in a way where their standards of living can be increased. It should also be made into an industry which piques the interest of the youth. What you expected of this government was not fulfilled by them. The people were devoid of many things. This government robbed the people. Then they began selling off our resources. It is time that we bear these in mind and work towards developing this country.
අපි කළ මානුෂික මෙහෙයුමට විරුද්ධ රාජ්‍ය නොවන සංවිධානවල බලපෑමට
which is against our war heroes which has been influenced by NGOs was not concerned about national security or the people's safety. I will assure you we will not allow extremism or terrorism to raise its head in this country. We will not jeopardize the unity and sovereignty of the country. That is why we did not agree to any of the conditions put forward by Tamil extremist political parties.
තමයි අපි සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම ප්‍රතික්ෂේප කරේ.